Clinical Assessment of Voice Disorders, published by Intok. Normal and disordered voice. The human voice gives us our identity and personality, and it changes throughout our lives from birth through to senescence. It is actually difficult to simply define a normal voice, but it is usually described as having the following characteristics. It is not associated with discomfort or pain on phonation. Voice quality is an extremely important element in how well a message is communicated with positive and negative effects. A good voice can captivate our attention or stir our emotions and is an essential attribute for a performance level professional voice user such as an entertainer, an actor, or a broadcaster. However, a bad voice, which may sound strained, weak, rough, monotonous, or inappropriate in pitch, can cause the listener to become distracted and bored or lose concentration. Variations in voice quality can provide valuable cues about our current emotions, physical health, and psychological well-being. There is also a continuum between normal and disordered or pathological voice. Individuals with what an objective listener would consider a pathological voice may be quite comfortable with their voice quality considering it their voice, as long as it fulfills their functional needs. Indeed, abnormal speaking and singing voice qualities can sometimes help determine the personality and character of a professional voice. Patients seek help with their voice problem because they are suffering some form of disability that can take three main forms. 1. Impairment, which is a structural problem with the vocal apparatus, for example, a laryngeal tumor causing an alteration in function such as hoarseness. 2. Limitation in activity, for example, reduced vocal range in singing or voice tiring with use, and 3. Participation restriction. For example, not being able to work or sing in a choir as a result of the voice problem. http://www.who.in/topics/disabilities/n/closing parenthesis. The consequences of voice problems can be physical, functional, psychosocial, occupational, or financial. Normal and disordered voice production. To understand the link between impairment, activity limitations, and participation restrictions, it is important to briefly review the normal mechanism of voice production and how this mechanism can be affected by pathological processes. Normal voice production. Normal voice production, phonation, is discussed in detail in Chapter 4. Simplistically, voice production requires three processes. 1. An energy source, provided by the lungs. 2. A vibrating structure, usually the two vocal folds in normal voice production. And 3. A resonator, the vocal tract, table 6.1. The vocal folds are adducted and the free edges of the mucosal surfaces start to vibrate, causing compression followed by rarefaction of air molecules, which is the fundamental property of the generation of a periodic sound wave. The frequency of vibration of the vocal folds, fundamental frequency, is determined by their elastic properties and tensioning. Point 2. The actual sound that a listener hears, however, is determined by the resonance properties of the vocal tract. The resonance properties and the consequent filtering effect can be modulated by the shaping and structure of the vocal tract. The sound emitted from the mouth therefore consists of the fundamental frequency and the non-filtered multiples of the fundamental frequency, harmonics or overtones. This filtering effect results in concentrations of sound energy at specific frequency bands, formants, that we interpret as individual vowel sounds. Additional sound elements can be added by constricting parts of the vocal tract in production of consonants. Pathological processes causing voice problems. There are four main pathological processes that can contribute to the voice becoming disordered, table 6.1. It is essential that the presence or absence of these four processes is checked for systematically, particularly as voice disorders tend to be multifactorial, fig. 6.1. This also reduces the chances of overlooking pathologies, for example, a vocal fold paresis in cases of apparent muscle tension imbalance. Each pathological process can affect any part of the three essential elements of voice production, that is, breath control, vocal fold vibration, and resonance. This is determined by careful history and examination, occasional specialist assessments, and probe therapy or empirical treatment. However, by looking for evidence for each of the four etiologic factors individually, the clinician is able to target the treatment more precisely. Primary abnormal breathing patterns, muscle tension imbalance of respiratory muscles, are a common cause of voice disorders, resulting in inefficient speech breathing patterns. By relying on the accessory respiratory muscles, high clavicular breathing pattern, rather than the diaphragm, patients may feel they are running out of air when they talk. In paradoxical vocal cord dysfunction, when there is adduction of the vocal cords during inspiration causing inspiratory stridor, there may be associated dysphonia. Disease processes may not be isolated to the respiratory muscles, or the effects on the voice may be overshadowed by the respiratory symptoms. There is a huge amount of reserve in the system and also in the ability to compensate, so the effects of chest disease may not be apparent until they are quite severe. In the most extreme situation, the patient may be aphonic due to the effort required in breathing. When present, voice problems include running out of air while speaking, weakness or breathiness of the voice, an inability to control the pitch or loudness, a lack of volume, and/or an inability to project the voice. Dysfunction of vibratory apparatus. To vibrate efficiently and effectively, the vocal cords need to come together and oscillate in a controlled, regular manner. A gap between the vocal folds causes breathiness, whereas irregular vibration or involvement of supraglottic structures causes roughness. Hoarseness is the perception of voice abnormality, which can be due to breathiness, roughness, or a combination of the two. In summary, if air is allowed to escape through the vocal folds from incomplete closure, glottal gap, then a breathy quality will be added to the voice. Abnormalities of the mass, the layered structure, intentioning, or the elasticity of the vocal folds will cause them to vibrate in a disordered and irregular, aperiodic manner. This will cause roughness, strain, or pitch abnormalities. Supraglottic structures such as the false folds, aryepiglottic folds, and arytenoid mucosa may also be induced to vibrate. This may be in addition to, or more rarely replace vibration of the vocal folds causing deepening of the pitch and roughness of the voice. Clinical assessment. A key responsibility as a health professional is to provide an accurate diagnosis to avoid injudicious surgery or prolonged voice therapy that can have detrimental effects on the voice or, at the very least, be a waste of time and resources. Other patient relevant factors that should be taken into consideration during a consultation are listed in Table 6.4. Clinical setting. Ideally, all voice disordered patients should be managed by an ENT surgeon and speech pathologist, SP, with a specialized interest in voice disorders. Different models of working exist, such as independent working but an integrated team approach, a joint voice clinic, SP plus ENT, parallel clinics, SP-led clinic with ENT input available, and SP alone, SP sees triaged referrals. The availability of these services is determined by the enthusiasm and collective experience of the team members, the types of referrals seen in the department, and pragmatism. Other members of a voice disorders service may include a singing teacher, clinical psychologist, osteopath, and physiotherapist. A key element of a voice clinic is the availability of stroboscopy. This is a pragmatic tool for the detailed assessment of the vibrating vocal folds, see Chapter 7. Other imaging techniques such as high-speed digital video recording and video chemography are gaining in popularity and are useful in understanding complex vibratory behavior. Other common methods of assessment include acoustic analysis, electromyography, electrolaryngography, and aerodynamic measurements, see Chapter 7. These can be used to provide supporting evidence for the diagnosis, the objective evaluation of severity, and specific outcome measures. Voice quality. Creaky voice. Breathy voice. Whispery voice. Diplophonia. Tremor. Fundamental frequency and pitch of the voice. Too high. Singers. Loudness of the voice. Too loud. Other throat symptoms. Further evaluation. Summary. Clinical assessment of